Rastafari, Shalom. These, you know, we'd like to begin by encouraging ones to go to YouTube and type in these channel names and, you know, check out the works. These are good works, you know. Just we've, as far as we are aware, these channels on YouTube's, you know, and we're joyful and glad and honored to be able to say that are managed by I&I brothers and sisters, you know, to I&I family. These channels have been bringing forth and uploading just awesome, great, you know, just great material, good works, you know, and we highly recommend them. There's no reason why any Rastafari, true and faithful, can't find or make the time to learn and receive, you know, of the many blessings within I&I people, you know. And so we highly encourage ones to do so. These are works that are at least for us personally are worthy of high praise, and we give thanks for them. I mean, it's not even a joke. We ain't even trying to get on no one's good side. Each one of our brothers and sisters have been given just, you know, different attributes and different skills and personalities and talents and stuff like that. And so, you know, it would do us good to share in some of that, you know, because each brother, each sister has much to offer, and we are very appreciative of it. We give thanks, and you know, we encourage ones to take part in this. You know, if ones be of a willing heart, nonetheless, you know, go to YouTube channel Wendy Mandela on YouTube, Lich Mikhail Tafara on YouTube, Beruku One on YouTube, plus Michael HaileSelassie on YouTube, and Game Amp Me on YouTube. You know, if we fail to mention other channels, it's because we're not aware of them, and these in particular have been uploading recent material. You know, Word Sound Power Manifest, another one, you know, we forgot to type in, you know, but make sure to check out I&I Brothers and Sisters channels, and there's much that we can learn from them. So now, going forward to this reasoning, the book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 11, verse 1. We are reading from the Old Schofield Study Bible, and the title is The Davidic Kingdom Set Up, the King's Ancestry. Verse 1 reads, "And there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots." So we have to make note that the focus of this verse is the rod. And so, "And there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse." So we have a stem, we have a tree trunk, a cut off tree, you know. We have a trunk, a stem, the stem of Jesse, a circumcised stem, we could say. You know, cut off, no longer producing. From it come forth a rod. From it come forth a rod. Now, we have to, you know, we have to be well aware that we're not talking about the stem of Jesse, we are talking about the rod, which is the main focus of the verse. And so, continuing, it reads, "And a branch shall grow out of his roots." Like we said before, we're not talking about the stem, the cut-off, circumcised stem of Jesse, we're talking about the rod. And so it's not, at least personally, the way that we know this to be, is that this is not talking about the roots of Jesse, rather the root of the rod that sprang out of the circumcised stem of Jesse. So we have the ancestry of Jesse, you know, rooted, but then we have a circumcision and the cutting off of that branch, but still from that same line, although not entirely directly, but not entirely cut off from it, there happens something which ones like to ones would recognize it as a virgin birth, a miraculous springing forth out of a sudden, a quickening, a, you know, a life, a random life source springing out from itself. And what we try to say is that a branch shall grow out of his roots, out of the roots of the rod, not out of the roots of Jesse, for that hath already been cut off, but still not completely cut off. You know, still the rod still pertaining to the ancestry and lineage of what once was the natural and flesh root of the stem, which is the stem of Jesse, now cut off, but not completely severed or cut off from its natural component and natural source, you know? So we can say here that this rod miraculously springing forth, taking root of itself, something that is an end within itself, you know, not needing any other thing to be what it itself is. And so we have a rooting and a miraculous, coming forth of a rod out of the already circumcised stem of Jesse, and out of that rod shall come forth shall grow a branch. So a branch. Now, okay, where should we start? We have the rod. The rod is the righteousness. It is Jesus the Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach. We have the roots. The roots is HaileSelassie first. Not the roots of Jesse, not the flesh, but the spiritual, the quickening of the spirit, that the manifestation of the will of the spirit, not entirely cut off from the natural, but still severed and born in and of itself, as we have with the case of Joseph and Mariam bringing forth Jesus the Christ coming forth out of the spirit, not out of the root, but not necessarily cut off from that root, still pertaining to the natural, but born of the spiritual. And so we have this root that sustains the rod, is to whom judgment and vengeance is given, the king of kings of Ethiopia, the root, the nourisher, the nutritioner, the sustainer, sustaining this rod, springing forth out of a suppose it, or out of something thought to be cut off and dead and no longer producing, you know, out of this comes forth a rod. And so going forward, we have the branch. The branch is us as Rastafari. In the Gospel of St. John, Jesus himself says, I am the vine and y'all be the branches. Without me, you can't do nothing. And, without me, you can't bear fruit, stuff like that. And so, New Testament, Jesus himself declares that we be the branch. And this branch is not just one branch. I mean, it's a branching out. And so, one important note to keep is, and Nick mentioned, is that, how do we know Rastafari is that branch that pertains to the rod, which is Jesus the Christ, which is rooted in HaileSelassie first, you know, God the Father, Christ in his kingly character? Well, because of the fruit, we do bear fruit. And if we do bear good fruit, then surely we are of that good tree, coming from that good root, from, you know, in a way descendant and still pertaining to the ancestry of that old root, which was cut off, the natural, but still pertaining to the rod, not completely cut off, but as we said, not born of the natural, but rather the spiritual. So, going forth, the stem, the trunk, the death, the being cut off, separated, holy to Jah Rastafari. And so this rod springing forth out of this thought to this stem, which could be seen as no longer bringing forth life. This rod coming forth, manifesting itself in the quickening of the spirit, the reviving of the spirit, the will of the Holy Spirit that is good, making itself, imposing itself upon creation, you know, but still tied to the natural, although not completely. So now, let's see. This event can be explained, as we made mention, in Jesus, the birth of the Christ child, and in the case of the union coming together of Queen Maked of Ethiopia, of Sheba, and King Solomon of Jerusalem, and the coming forth of Menelik, Dawit the second, Menelik the first, you know? And so, which is one that would be, those would be a couple of examples of the will of the Holy Spirit that is good, imposing its will upon all creation, demonstrating its superior control of all things, you know? And so, and thus making the will of the good Holy Spirit inevitable and ultimately that which is to prevail without any threat whatsoever, for it is in and of itself. It needs nothing outside of itself to be what it already is, you know, so something pure, something applicable, and something everlasting. So now, continuing, you know, instead of just going forth with all this information, we weren't really even sure how to bring this forth, but we'll just kind of like improvise from now on. What can we get from this? Well, one thing is that, you know, oftentimes we hear, you know, within scripture, the wheels within a wheel. So basically we have here a rooting, a rod still connected to its natural, but cut off, but in the same way cut off from the natural root. And this rod being rooted in HaileSelassie first, branching out into, you know, the healing of the nations, which is Zion Diaz Rastafari, you know, shedding leaves, shedding fruit, so that this world, this earth may be green and may be sustained by the leaves of our branch, you know, by the fruits of our being. And so the most significant and important lesson or teaching that we can receive from this is how extremely important it is to understand that there is an equal partnership within this Trinity of the good Holy Spirit manifesting itself and fulfilling its ultimate desire, its own will, and imposing it without any disruption or delay or any obstacle, any difficulty, with ease, you know, demonstrating its ultimate control over all things and its superior strength and power, and how, you know, nothing outside of itself can impose any threat or outside influence upon it, for it is in complete control. So now, this government, which is composed of the root, HaileSelassie first, God the Father, Christ in his kingly character, elect of God, conquering land of the tribe of Judah, King of Kings of Ethiopia, his imperial majesty, and the rod of righteousness, in whom is Jesus the Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach, and the branches, which is I and I Rastafari, that in due season shall bear fruit, and in truth, good fruit we bear and bring forth. So now, as we said, the most significant aspect that we can learn from this is the responsibility of I and I within this government of this life cycle, this process, and this tree. Cut off from the flesh, born of spirit, erected, established, exalted in righteousness, spreading out to, you know, in triumph, prevailing, conquering all that is not, and establishing all that is, and bringing forth abundant fruit and leaves and fruit and life, you know, to all peoples that are willing to receive of this which is and not of that which is not. All of the responsibilities within this government are necessary, and thus it is extremely important for us Rastafari to accept our role and responsibility and to make a decision this day as to how we are to go about this. Are we to look back, turn back, and choose another way, which is ultimately death, or continue on forward to the fulfillment of this process, life cycle? If anyone's know a little bit of planting, gardening, we have a root system, a foundation, and we have a stem. The root collects nutrients, all the necessary minerals. It is the nourisher, the sustainer. It maintains the plant or the tree. It is the essence, the strength, the foundation, the basis of this life process, life cycle. The stem is the way. It is the communication, the way, the intermediate, the connection to that root system, to the sustaining force or source, which is the root system. Through this stem, which highway, or King's Highway, through this channel, is carried out all works, all messages, all information passes through this, all interaction between the root and its eventual desire, which is the branching and the bringing forth of fruit. Through this rod of righteousness, through Jesus the Christ, it is the only way to fulfill this life cycle. If we're explaining ourselves, we hope we're doing an okay job. So now, this stem eventually branches out, and now these branches are that which are of the root, in and through the stem, and which eventually spread out to do what is required, and in this case to bear fruit in due season. The branches, the purpose are to hold the leaves which receive the light. We as Rastafari, we receive the light. The light shine in darkness, but darkness comprehended not, but I and I receive joyfully. And so we receive these light rays and are trapped by the leaves and down the branch, through the branch, in and through the rod, the stem finds its way to the root, so that through the process of photosynthesis, that light energy can be regenerated. And so I will be replaced by the oncoming generation. This life cycle is our main focus, what we would want ones to learn. Yes, God the Father, in all His glory, is of high praise. The Son, to whom all things have been given, whom without no thing can be, is of high praise and glory, you know. But we too share equal responsibility within this triune government. And just know for a fact that no other will but the will of the good Holy Spirit will be made manifest and imposed upon creation regardless, with no exception. And so, if we as a branch fail to bring forth good fruit, we too shall be cut off. And so, it's something that we would do good to meditate and contemplate and reflect upon. If we are as the fig tree, which beareth not fruit, which was dried up, you know, almost instantly, we too, if we are as that fig tree, we too shall be cut off and, you know, and done away with for what need of a branch that beareth not good fruit in due season. What need of such waste of energy, you know. The Father desired them that do according to His glory the word of God, and thus fulfill its role and responsibility within this process. And so, going forward, a way that we could hope to explain that just slightly better is okay, here we go. The next verse, chapter 11 of the book of the prophet Isaiah, verse 2, and the title to this is The Source of the King's Power, the Sevenfold Spirit. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. So we have a sevenfold power, the sevenfold spirit, the king's source, the king's power. This root, which is sevenfold, must be equally made manifest, you know, from the source, the root, guided through the way, and ultimately fulfilled in the branch, branching out, as it is, as the roots sustain, you know, this life cycle to the ground, we too branch out to the heavens, and thus, you know, declaring all things to be under I and I, as Rastafari, you know. Let's see, sevenfold, so, seven, Sheba, fulfillment. So, if we don't keep our part and do our responsibility in this cycle, we inevitably shall be cut off. And so, you know, Rastafari, I consider that we take it not the name of Vine Die God and Father in vain. You know, we value it, give it meaning and content, you know, and thus fulfill and accomplish our responsibility. So now, we'll do this. We'll do, see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I mean, right away, we could see so many different similarities, for all things are of one Creator, one God, Ahadu Amlak. All things being of one Creator, thus all being imprinted with the hand of with the fingerprint of the hand that created all things, you know. So we have a tree with its roots and its branches. We could see so many different things here. In order not to kind of make this any more confusing than it might already be, we'll go ahead and just conclude by establishing the sevenfold application of such, you know. Which is Shiva, the fulfillment, the manifestation, the completion. And so, you know, this ties in perfectly to the book of Revelation chapter 4, to the book of Isaiah chapter 6, and, you know, the appearance of God in glory. We could do with this design pretty much anything that we wish to impose upon it. But, you know, be it a DNA strand, be it the tree of life, be it the cube and you know, the, let's see, the cross, the Star of David, the all kinds of things, basically. But the source here is the Spirit, born of the Spirit. You see, we have the root, the natural root, which is not completely cut off, but severed, the stem that is cut off of Jesse. And then we have a miraculous birth, rooting of itself, which is the will of the Creator Spirit that is good, holy, imposing its desire upon His own creation, which is the center of all things, the Spirit of that which chooses to be what it already is, and its fulfillment in in movement and the amounts of the amount of the amount of let's see the distance, the amount of distances which it can navigate from itself, from its own source, and thus fulfilling the attitude or the personality which it intended to fulfill in the manner of which it travels freely of equal distance to all possible manifestation, points of manifestation. But we have, most importantly, the root source, the source of the existence is of the Spirit, you know. And so the fall, even, I mean, this just came to mind, the fall could be, we have the source of origin, and then we have the fall of man to the natural, which was cut off but not entirely, and then we have a process of movement and regeneration. And so, basically, but the most important thing here is, you know, I and I is going to be cut off, and I don't testify and speak the things which must be spoken, you know, and fulfill this cycle completely, wholly. The message we wish to bring forth is, the circumcision. You know, for those growing in Rastafari, be patient. It's no hurry. But to those a bit more mature, we must declare what is true. Part of our judgment is when we are in a situation in which we are able to testify and declare that which is true. Will we do it? Or will we hold back? Will we stop ourselves from doing so because of fear of hurting one's feelings, or because of the obvious implications of completely shattering the imagination of an individual and you know, confronting him with the challenge of having to accept that quite possibly very truly everything that he ever thought was is in fact not. You know, it's heartbreaking. And we overstand. It's difficult, you know. Oftentimes when we have to do this, we do it gracefully, mercifully, and we at times we let the individuals know that this is just as hard for us to say and destroy their imagination, their dreams, and their illusions. And it is just as difficult for us to be circumcised from the flesh and just accept what is to be and of necessity be spoken and revealed without regards to man or person or you know, consequences as far as the reception of the message. But in that moment we are confronted with, are we worthy of fulfilling circumcision in its fullness and bringing forth the message, you know? And it's not to, you know, our attempt is never to destroy anyone's faith or anything, but what is true is true. And it is very difficult, you know. We feel, honestly, we feel the pain of, or the heavy burden of the prophets of having to declare those things which are not necessarily, not at all times, wanted to be received by the multitudes. But we do say that it is our job, and so we have a choice to make. Will we hold back because we might not want to hurt someone's feelings? Or do we just, you know, prove ourselves worthy, tested, gold, tried by fire, and declare that which is, you know? And no doubt it's difficult, but we must remember that born of spirit requires responsibility to branch out and make manifest that fruit which will heal all nations and bring forth that fruit that will sustain this earth with life and food that we may all live. So, you know, this is in so many ways so very, very, very important. That which is, you know, and trust in our Lord God, Jesus Christos, in the power of the Holy Trinity, HaileSelassie first, trust that Jah would not put us in a situation in which we would be then attacked for our declarations and stuff like that, or that no such hard feelings will be held against I and Jah. You know, this is something that we know for a fact. You know, Jah never make it so that ones rise up in anger against I and Jah because of the fact that we testified that which is true. Alongside that comes a shield, a protection of the star, a fulfillment of that which is required, and thus in accordance, in agreement with nature and creation, and thus aligned perfectly, shielded by nature and by the forces of that which is, and protected for that which is for the works that are good, you know, and through Jesus our Christ, you know, which makes it all possible, whom without nothing can be. This is what it is, you know. We'll never be put in harm's way. If harm's way comes to pass, it'll be in other forms and manners. But you know, if we go forth and humbly, meekly, and just graciously and mercifully declare those things that are, you know, we should be okay, we should be fine, and even though it's hard for the individuals receiving it, never are we to doubt that we are in good hands and that all will be well. Because this ain't no joke. I mean, this is it takes balls to speak those things, you know, to people. and sometimes, I mean, don't doubt that there'll be an individual that could pretty much crush you alive, you know. But, you know, Jah will put it in his hands to you know, keep his part in keeping I and I safe from any such vengeance, you know, due to the work that we make manifest, which is required, you know, Jah handleth all them things. But yeah, definitely this is, and another thing, whenever we declare those things which are, we've noticed that the reason we are very successful, because our ministry is not necessarily on the YouTubes, our ministry is in life, because that's where it impacts all peoples the most. It don't matter what life you live, if you're Rastafari, anyone that comes in contact to your life will be impacted by the truth that is Rastafari, and will rearrange and reshape everything that surrounds each I individually. Our life and liberty, just living and being ourselves and holding our conversations to that which is good and righteous, that is our ministry. That is where we are most successful and conquer all things, you know. Because it is Rastafari face to face with the wicked, the heathen, and the nations of this world, and the confrontation that is inevitably a victory for I and I as Rastafari, you know, to whom all things have been given, whom have inherited all things, you know, rulers upon this earth to bring this good government, which is the kingdom of heaven, you know, made manifest upon this earth here, being as priest, ministering to the Most High Himself, Jah Rastafari. And so, okay, we kind of have another thought to make mention concerning that, but kind of, it doesn't come to mind. So, with that, we will conclude, and it seems like we pretty much got all that we wanted to speak covered. Okay, yeah, we were actually just trying to make time so that it would come to mind. yeah, so that's what that was, but it was necessary, so, just kind of played it off. So, now that it came back to mind, it is very necessary to make mention of this, is, when we go out there, we declare that which is with full authority. Before the eyes of these individuals whom come in contact with I and I as Rastafari, never have they or probably will ever hear such declarations that are evident in evidently self-evident in full authority. I guess to simplify that, we didn't even make sense to ourselves. Anyways, you know, like kind of the scripture, New Testament, when it said, you know, never any man spoke with such authority, that be I and I as Rastafari, and that is what makes everything just so simple. Whenever we declare what is to be, confidently, truly, and surely, conversation is over. Most people don't accept it and try their hardest, and therefore to erase those seconds of their lives and pretend it never happened, but still, you know, Rastafari prevaileth, and no challenge come upon I and I, to whom full authority hath been given. And so we must declare those things without a doubt. If not, the wicked heathen will seek to eat you alive, and they will do so by feeding off of fear and weakness. You know, it's difficult, but in time, you know, we will all learn to do accordingly. But yeah, you know, when we declare those things which are, declare them with full authority, for nothing else can be. Just a quick example before we conclude is that when people want to, you know, comment on what is true, whatever it is that they comment, it's usually to kind of like create some vain source of lack or unsurety or lack of security by bringing forth some kind of like fallacies and logic which want to bring forth the idea of doubt. You know, just to get rid of any kind of response as such, we make it well known that we are not talking about a belief, you know, kind of like if they want to bring forth some, well, that's what you believe and stuff like that. You know, it's to take full authority, it is necessary to just clarify that we are not talking about ideas or philosophies or thoughts and lay it to them straight. Listen, yes, the Christ is not white, and that is just what it is. All facts lead to that. Truth cannot be anything else. You've been lied to. There's nothing you could do about it. We're not speaking of belief or religion. This is what it is. I don't care what you want to believe or accept. Regardless, what is true is true. I don't want to convert you to anything. Don't make a difference in my life if you accept what is true or not. It doesn't make it anything other than true. You know, like, put people in the situation in which they have to just seriously contemplate concerning their own personal beliefs. I mean, we'll conclude with this. To the point where, actually, the plantation owner, the plantation owner of where we work at, his son, we're conversing, right? And, you know, we're blabbing, we're talking, declaring His Majesty to fullness, and then it leads up to a point in which we say something to the effect of, all right, you know, if you don't want to accept His Majesty to be who he be, you know, in his fullness and divinity, you know, we said, we encourage and recommend that you study up on Haile Selassie first, the man. Study up on his history. We assure you that there's not another person that you will learn more from than Haile Selassie first. You know, if you don't want to accept him to be that which he is, you know, research him and learn from him at just looking at him as any regular man. This individual, he responded with a loud yell and scream of, you know, desperate, that why couldn't we just understand that we don't all have to believe the same? And in that moment, we were like, you're right. Forgive us, you know. It's not given to all peoples, you know. I and I be chosen, and some people just are not worthy. And so from there, you know, we get this look, like, you know, we don't let down. It is what it is. You know, he of a truth declared that he just wanted to pretend and make believe what he wanted to make believe, and that why couldn't I accept that he doesn't have to accept the truth, you know, and let him be. And I did tell him, you know, forgive me, you know, it's not customary and rightful that we kind of like take from one his God-given individuality and gift of free mind and reason to choose that which he wants to choose, you know, even though if what you choose is incorrect and stuff like that. And, you know, but we just bring this forth because all this is necessary, and it's difficult, you know, it's heartbreaking at times. Because, I mean, we have to look at these people just completely dead and shattered, you know, to where, you know, they got to go back to the drawing board from scratch and realize that for the last 20, if they're 25 years old, for the last 25 years, they've been lied to, and nothing that they thought is. And so, you know, it all has to do with the circumcision and the trial, you know, gold tried by fire, and the fulfillment, you know, bringing forth abundant fruit. And so, you know, we hope this reasoning is of good use to Andai. As Rastafari, Shalom. Rastafari.